Okay, so this one's what you wanted to call it, what, Dad?
The humble potato chip. Where did it come from?
Okay, so where did it come from?
I recently heard that Smith's chips have celebrated 90 years of the humble potato chip. Sorry, I have to argue with that, because it was invented, and I mean invented, not just introduced, by Browns, funny enough, Brown Smith, but no, Browns, and they introduced it in a little cafe in Wagga. It was in Baylor Street, about 100 metres from the railway station, so I remember it very well. And they may not have invented this particular thing, the oil they used, but they were the first I ever knew of any chip shop anywhere using big barrels of oil. And they cleaned it out every night, according to legend or them. But they would produce layers and layers and layers of these potato chips, and you actually saw them do it, and you could either buy it hot in a wax paper bag, or you could buy them cold. They have a whole row of these potato chips, but they're only like 50 grams, I suppose, you'd be the size of a pack. And they would cost something of the order of 6 pence, which is what, 5 cents now. 6 pence was a significant amount of money in the mid-50s. It would get you into the picture theatre. It would get you a thoroughly good milkshake. They hadn't heard of thick shakes yet, but a thoroughly good milkshake. But 6 pence wasn't too bad. Anyway, late in the 50s, they sold out. Browns just disappeared. They sold out, and the next minute I used to go to Sydney quite a lot to visit my auntie. The next minute I go to Sydney, I go into this shop, and here's Smith's crisp. And they went nowhere near as good as Browns, but I guess they were probably older chips, because you usually just get them fresh off the almost off the grill, but. Yeah, it was quite a remarkable thing that they've never ever acknowledged. I don't believe they have ever acknowledged where the chips came from, but now you know.
Did Smiths buy out Browns, or you don't know that?
No, I believe. I understand they bought out Browns.
Okay.
Because Browns disappeared and suddenly Smith's chips were available.
Okay.
Too much of a coincidence there to be anything else.
Yeah, right. And they were that oil you're talking about, it was vegetable oil, was it? Not an animal fat?
No, it wasn't animal fat. They ceased using animal fat. They introduced, as far as I know, they were the first to introduce oil, whether it be vegetable oil or canola or whatever it is. It wouldn't be canola. I think that's modern day. But no, it would be vegetable oil, I would say.
Okay. Wow, so that's pretty cool. So they were, you could get them hot, fresh out of the fryer.
Or in a packet already done the day before. They wouldn't last long. People would come in flocking in to get these things.
Yeah, right.
They were a new thing. They were damn good.
Yeah.
And, oh boy, did they crackle.
Did they flavour them, or was it salt?
No, it was just salt.
Okay.
Just salt. Much later, they introduced things like Smith's, introduced all sorts of things, chicken chips and all that stuff.
Yeah, it's amazing because crisps are all over the world now. And actually, even the different brands around the world, I think they're all Smith's. Like, I'm trying to think, I can't think of what the English brand is or the American brand, but I think they're actually all owned by Smith's.
They'd all be a runoff.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's fascinating. Thanks for clearing it up.
my pleasure, and I hope Smiths don't sue me.
Yeah, well, it's funny. I wonder why they're saying that they've been around 90 years if they've only... They've clearly been What? How many years is it? It's like more like 50 years or 60 years.
Well, of course, the name Smith has been around for millennium.
Yeah, millennia. Right. Maybe they met that as a company. Because, for instance, there's a company that comes to my mind for some reason. They made waffle irons, and now they're the leading gym equipment manufacturer and barbell maker and weight plate maker in Sweden. So they say however many years their company's been around, let's say 100 years, but for the first 30 or 40 years they were waffle makers. They weren't, you know, waffle iron, mate, you know, the cooking thing. You know, they made the cooking tool.
Yeah, they were making them when I was a kid.
Yeah, and now they make barbells. So they've been, and, you know, it's the same company. It's been around a very long time, but they're making different things. They don't even make, they stopped making the waffle makers, and then they made barbells, you know?
Yep. Well, I'm 78 shortly, and they've been around as long as I've been around.
Who has?
They're waffle irons and offal irons, jaffle irons.
Yeah, right. But with Smith's crisps, they weren't around for 90 years. They weren't. They came out after. So if you were eating them at 10 years old, we're talking about 60 years ago or something.
Close to 70 years.
Yeah, so they're not 90 years in chip making anyway.
No.
All right. Well, very interesting. I love Smith's crisps. Everyone does. Everyone loves chips.
Yep.
But actually, I have seen chips made, cut really thin like Smith's crisps are, and cooked in the oil, made fresh by a chef when I was working at a restaurant as a cleaner, you know, the dish pig.
Well, you can do it yourself.
Yeah, yeah, and they when they come out hot, they're delicious, and then even, you know, when they cool down a couple of hours later, they're delicious, so yeah.
Sometimes.
Yeah. Oh, good on you, Dad, all right. Well, can't wait to hear another story soon.
Yeah.